Profanity going on here in the Board of Supervisors here at the Rood Center, so I'll just kind of wait outside until some of this profanity dies down.
That is not the way
that's
we
are. So we're the way going we are. Through.
No,
that is not with us.
So no, I don't know why you took it, though.
What was that? Well, this is part of the just everything that's going on. And
no,
why,
it's not what's going on.
I didn't say that. Okay, no, please. I came out here to tell my viewers that there's profanity going on inside, and I'm going to step outside until it's over.
But why are you here, though?
I'm here for this meeting, yes.
Well, then you can't include that. That should be very separate or
well,
not at all.
I'm already live, so it's included. I'm a member of the press.
He can include it because it's free speech. Hey, there's
some stuff going on inside there. Well, I think the people have got it now because you guys
already got a hold of that. We're hoping, but you didn't.
I didn't even have a chance to say anything before I stepped out.
Oh, you still have a chance.
Well, I don't think I need to now. I think you guys already explained it.
But is our, you know, yeah.
All right, sounds like the profanity has died down in here, so we'll. Yes, we're here. Reporters, she's over here.
Oh, hi. Are you from back in?
No, I'm
from Korea. Okay,
do
you
remember the
So there was some controversy earlier this week regarding folks trying to get access to one of the elections offices earlier. So some folks wanted to clear the air regarding their side of the story. So that's what we're here for.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today is January 28th. My name is Calvin Clark. I'm a voter.
this constitutes, this recall effort constitutes the efforts of many, many individuals and proponents in each of the five districts in Nevada County. There are only five districts and only five supervisors as part of the Board of Supervisors, who is the legislative body in Nevada County. As many of you have already heard through different sources, one of them is the union article and the press release that was done by Natalie Dona and Gregory Diaz, which unfortunately had some very glaring and very obvious misstatements or statements. I would like to make the following statement at this press conference here in Nevada County, California, regarding Nevada County politics entering in to the functional departments of a constitutionally established county, one of the over 3,000 counties in the United States. This press conference is due to the election office closure and politicization by Nevada County. I mean, that's pretty complicated. It's simply the politics of this county that they've taken over the departments and implemented kind of a political discrimination. And this recall is not a political effort. We are a nonpartisan grassroots organization of just citizens in each of the districts. The reason why this became really interesting is because of recent policy changes that were done constitutionally, and they were done by a group of people starting in the elections office. And some of that information that happened was on the 19th of January when we went into the elections office, and we were treated with disrespect and people saying they weren't going to help us. And the video of that is posted on recallnevadacounty.com, and it shows the assistant register of voters, her name is Natalie Adona, making statements that were very concerning and trying to stop any service from happening because the citizens who had been going there for many, many months have gone in without masks and were not asked to leave through force. But what had happened is the Board of Supervisors, of course, have some misdeeds, and we went after them with the reasons for recall. And part of those reasons were that they concealed facts, and they also exposed the county to many liabilities to the citizens. There was also a concern on the 20th, after the 19th, when we were treated so unfairly. You can watch that video. On the 20th, there was three of our volunteers that went up to the elections office, and they were treated with a locked door. There was now a new policy that the door was locked, and we were unable to just open the door and go in. Instead, there was a doorbell placed on the door, and the volunteers rang the doorbell. The door opened. As it opened, a person thought, one of the persons, an unknown woman, we know who she is, she's a volunteer from District 2. She chose to start to proceed. She had her left hand behind her, and she went to take a step to go in, and suddenly the hand was placed upon her shoulder, and she was pushed back, and the door was pushed onto her, hurting her foot. She was injured in this new policy change that was enforced by a staff member that probably didn't know any better, but the Register of Voters, and which is Gregory Diaz, and the Assistant Register of Voters, Natalie Adona, knew that this had happened, but only through hearsay. They were not witnesses to this event. There was one security personnel that was inside the building, that inside the elections office, that did not answer the door. So I would just like to finish the statement that this concerns so many people in the county. Once this word got out that you are no longer given free access to your county, that all of a sudden there's new policies that are being implemented by people, and they're not publishing it. And to me, that's just really concerning. Although this attack appears to be an isolated event, the reasons for recalling the Board of Supervisors appears to have upset the elections official, resulting in injury, serious county liabilities, and additional malfeasance. For more information and to see the letter that has been written by the attorney representing the grassroots effort of proponents and voters in Nevada County, please go to recallnevadacounty.com, and you'll be able to download this letter to address to Gregory Diaz, Natalie Adona, Heidi Hall, Ed Schofield, Dan Miller, Sue Hook, Artie Bolick, and Allison Lehman, who is county council. She's the CEO, and to Catherine Elliott, who is county council. And so I'm going to now close by saying, you know, I've been coming to this county since 1976, and to the offices in the county since 1976. I find it incredibly upsetting that if I can't get normal access to the building, what is somebody like an elderly person gonna feel, or parents that are trying to just find answers, or people who are perhaps even homeless or having a difficult time? We found that during the storm that happened on the 20th through the 27th, they closed the county offices except to Dan Miller. He had special privileges given to him. We heard through the video and through Gregory Diaz, when we asked the question, Gregory Diaz, why did Dan Miller have special access to the elections office to file his answer to the reasons for recall, which is part of that process? Gregory Diaz stated that the county council had contacted him. So to me, that's kind of concerning. That's what I remember she's saying, remember Gregory Diaz saying, that the CEO, Allison Lehman, had been involved in the communication. And who is she an employee of? She's an employee of the Board of Supervisors. And so that's concerning. To me, that's politicking the elections office. And it's kind of upsetting. The other thing that's a little bit interesting is, you know, when people reach out to write an article in the paper representing the newspaper, I would highly recommend that they make retractions when they find out that they are wrong. And I think overall, the people in Nevada County have been very incredibly consistent about, we just want an honest government, we want to be forgiving people, we want to have resolve and move forward. Let the voters decide if they want to recall their supervisors. Don't use the elections office as a political tool to stop a standard nonviolent process that's called recall, which has been established in the United States and established as a redress of grievances in California since 1911. You know, I would say also that I really dispute the county claims. Straight up, those county claims that they've made should be checked and fact-checked. And we've been fact-checked, and we've been nothing but smeared in the recent news. And I think it would do well that the county read the letter from the attorney, which we served them today as we went upstairs. And by the way, the elevator's been broken. So the second floor, which has the county council office, the Board of Supervisors office, the county CEO's office, the sheriff's office, all of these offices, including the grand jury, and by the way, you can join the grand jury and then put that up. But if you can look right over here to my left, that's where the elevator is. And notice it says caution, and there's no access for disabled people to get upstairs to get service in this county. And so that, and then recently we just had a gentleman right before this press conference come in and ask for help to get some staff member, and it took over 15 minutes, and finally that staff member came down and went outside and is finally helping somebody. But when you hand documents that are really vital to the records office, which is closed today, you want to see it get scanned. It's not something that you want that gets changed. Or, you know, you want to follow it right to the filing. This is not a game. It's not to be trifled with. The elections office and is also the county recorder's office. And this is where sacred documents that hold in place a limited government under law is supposed to happen. How do you know that it's going to be filed properly? When you, I mean, so far, I mean, we're being assaulted now to just go into an office. And you know, the proof is in the action. We have two videos regarding that entry on the 20th. And we, this one person who was entering the office up there, called the elections office, was injured. We have two videos of that, which is legal evidence. Do we really want a lawsuit in this county? No, we really don't. We just want to be unrestrained in the legal processes. Once again, they're nonviolent. To have accountability, to hold accountable our departments and the conduct of the people, especially this board of supervisors who made no statement. We ask them, we pledge them to make a statement that told Dr. Kellerman that, you know what, that behavior of gesturing and shooting on mass citizens in this county is unacceptable. We pled with the Board of Supervisors to ask Dr. Kellerman to do that, and they didn't do that, and that's one of the reasons for recall. I don't think I have much more to say other than it's time, the time has come, the Nevada County gets back in order, and the people in this county are going to put it back in order, and they're going to do it very soon. We are waiting for an update on the recall circulation petitions. Once those petitions are given to us, it will begin the 120-day process of gathering signatures to hold accountable our five supervisors in Nevada County. I urge you to consider the reasons for recall. Look them up for yourself on recallnevadacounty.com and decide for yourself. We can compare today tyranny to freedom just by understanding those reasons. And I urge you to protect the children in this county from an abusive, and all citizens, from an abusive and overreaching, bloated government that has no meaningful restraints. Thank you very much. I'll take a few questions if you have some. Go ahead. You can clap if you want.
Gavin, can I make a statement? I just heard from the Catherine Elliott, this counsel we were talking earlier, that Greg McGinnis is in his office right now.
Well, we'll follow that. We'll follow that step because I guess we made enough noise that now we're starting to open up some offices.
The elections office is open.
Wow, that would be fantastic. Great. Well, thank you, Dr. Wright.
You're welcome.
What
seems
to say that the county has been legally standing to enforce the mask mandate?
I'm sorry, could you repeat the question?
So what seems to say that the county has no legal standing to enforce the mask mandate? Is that?
Yeah, I would refer you to the letter by our attorney in regards to that. I think he uses the language that's really more accurate in describing that. I would recommend everyone in Nevada County and that Mike has that concern about enforcing the mask mandate in this county building or any other county building in California to go to Recall Nevada County and pull up that letter. I could read a small portion of that letter if that would give you something you're interested in hearing.
No, I read it.
Okay. And did you find a clause in the letter that gave you some
answer? I just want a clarification on that.
Uh-huh. And just for reference, did the KNCO or any of the media here have an understanding of that law? Because I'm
trying to say,
well, because sometimes the media has printed things that are really misleading. So in reference to that, local government
hasn't given any guidance on enforcement, and some local authorities say they won't enforce the state's order at all. Will anyone enforce, and there's, and this has to do with, there is enforceable laws and there are non-enforceable policies. And so this is a non-enforceable policy. This is not a law. A mandate is not a law.
Okay, do you feel the county is, or the clerk before his office is biased regarding the recall?
Well, initially, no, but after, I don't believe they're biased until we identified that they gave special privileges to Dan Miller. And I think the temperament, the attitude really changed drastically after that. I mean, we were simply pointing out that for some reason they gave him special permission, and they could have just been fair and straight across the board saying that, yeah, we had a major storm on January 19th and the offices are closed. But we were told that they would be open on Thursday, and we couldn't really prepare to recall petitions for circulation until we knew that there was there were answers from the Board of Supervisors. And then we found out that they passed the limitation of time on providing those. And as we asked them, we found out after that that they gave special permission on the 28th, and they had sought some counsel and said, well, we can extend the time. Why not extend the time fairly, which they made us wait till the 30th or till January 3rd when they opened? Why not make them wait the same? Why not be treated the same? And you know, this has to do with, your question has to do with why, or is there a change in attitude in the elections office?
It's just if you feel they are biased against your recall effort.
As far as yes or no, I would say on principle, I would say yes. They have acted and shown a very unorganized way.
I think it's slow to verify the petition.
Yeah, they used up all of the 10 days and haven't notified us that. I mean, we met with county council just before this, and they had stated, and that would be Catherine and Elliot, had stated that the 10th day was on Monday or on Saturday, and that, because it's the weekend, it would be happening on Monday when they open back up. Well, if they're not open today, plus she said when we challenged her, do you really know? And she goes, well, no, I don't really know. And do you really work for the elections office? It's something similar to what we asked her. And she doesn't. She's in a different department. Why is she giving us advice of what the elections officials are doing? I mean, did she have a meeting with them? And she told us she did that earlier when we met with her. So I'm concerned that there's just all this confusion by not only county council, maybe they're biased as well. We're finding that the elections office is becoming biased. Is it an example of misrepresentation and malfeasance from the Board of Supervisors trickling down and entering into every department in this county? It appears to be so. And I would challenge that they need to be the ones who prove that they're not doing it. Certainly having one of our voters get injured in their office when a new policy changed, and then they locked us completely out on Friday, that would have been the 21st of January. I'm really concerned that they're the ones who at this point need to prove that they are really about just helping the community and operating as our public servants.
If you're asking that she be fired and there be an apology?
Well, I think it's, you know, if we can't fire the supervisors, we have to start firing other county staff. I think it's going to happen. Because, you know, if people are politicizing the departments, I think everybody who's in that program who wants to change the county representative government, I think they all need to be fired if they're going to do that. Straight up, this is not, you know, Cambodia or Yugoslavia back in the day. This is not an invasion from some foreign government. This is right here in our local town where we're being told what to do and when to do it and how to do it. And they're the ones who are supposed to provide services for us. We were just upstairs and we went knocking on doors, and some of them were locked and no one answered. And one of the doors that answered was finally the Board of Supervisors. They let us come in the office. The nice person who was filling in for the clerk gave
opportunity to talk with her, and she stamped our document. We then went into the CEO's, well, we attempted to knock on the CEO's office door, and we found that there were no signs at the same time. There's no sign saying if no one answers the door, you know, call this, well, there is a few, call this number, but, you know, you drive so far to get here, and now you have to call, and now you have to wait to be served, and people didn't answer the call when we called in. We leave messages like we did this morning and today on the elections office phone number, which is, I have that right here, I'll just show you the number. It's so everybody knows, and they can call to see if they're being served, and maybe they want to check in. I mean, the union and the KNCO and other media outlets should have been calling the whole time while we're doing this recall if they're really interested in knowing what's going on in this county. And honestly, I didn't see a very good reporting yet on the Board of Supervisors meeting, you know, the passing of a drone ordinance that violates citizens' property rights and their unwarranted searches in the code enforcement. Why not with the sheriffs? They already have it. And the sheriffs, why do they need that? But not to change the subject. You know, getting access to your building, which is called the Nevada County Rood Center, it's the government building here in Nevada County where, you know, there's the building department, there's the Board of Supervisors chambers, but upstairs, I mean, once again, you don't have a way to climb the stairs, would that be considered, you know, ADA compliance? Yeah, no, I don't think so. And so, you know, we have a lot of disabled veterans and other things in this county that, you know, had they known this kind of, I mean, you know, we know the private sector has been sued a lot when disabilities, access is limited. We're just talking about access for me who can climb the stairs, for the rest of us who get access. And you know, here comes the county council. Maybe you'd like to make a statement.
No, I'm actually doing something else.
You don't want to make a statement?
No.
Okay. So, all right. Well, we gave her the opportunity. Maybe the media would be happy to check with her on making statements. So, as far as aside from the reasons for recall, which are significant, you know, just today alone is a reason that the people in this county would want to recall some supervisors. We went upstairs. And we got the kind of answers we got from finally when the CEO, Allison Lehman, came out. She was very, isn't she one of the highest paid officials in Nevada County? How much does she make? It's like almost $500,000. And she wanted to not answer our questions. And she didn't answer the questions that we asked. And you know, why are these offices closed? When will they be open? Things like that we asked. So I just urge everyone to think about what kind of responsibility your county government should have.
All right, thank you, Bill.
Thank you. Do you have any questions?
I just want to point out that I gave the elections office a call.
Great. We've got Gregory Diaz on the phone, and here's Calvin as well. I think we're having a press conference downstairs right now.
Good afternoon, Gregory. This is Calvin. Great. Hello, Gregory. It just happened that way. Somebody handed me a phone with you on it. Okay. And we will come in your office and sit down. Okay. We'll carefully approach your office, and we will be careful. We have some papers we would like to get signed. And if you leave the door open, we will stay out. We want to give you some papers that are stamped first, and you can initial them or put your signature on them so we know that they have officially been filed. They're papers of referencing the incident that happened where one of the voters attempting to enter your office was assaulted. We want you to receive it and stamp that you received it.
No, I want to come out. I just don't do what you're asking.
I'm sorry, Gregory, would you like to answer the question why all the other departments stamp a document when we submit it to their department? And you're refusing to stamp a document that we're submitting? Did you say you're the one who runs your department? Okay, all right, thank you. Okay, it looks like we're gonna go upstairs. Thank you everyone for being here.
Easy, you hear what he said? I run my department. I understand that. You run your department into the ground. Yeah.
Can I just ask you a question?
That can be, absolutely.
Thank you. If, I know it's public, you know, and I know we all have free speech, but I'm just wondering, I'm so curious about if someone's in a real mental stress situation, like really having a lot of stress. I'm just wondering, isn't there a
solution
to put him? I don't know where it would go. I have no idea.
Well, why the person, Matthew Coulter?
I don't know the name.
That's his name, yeah. We're friends. Actually, he wants me to document whenever he's out and about.
Really?
Because, yeah, he gets a lot of stuff happen to him.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Yeah, he has a Facebook page called Concerned Citizen on Facebook. It's pretty interesting.
I was surprised that you were, I just had a feeling like, why would, when someone's that upset, but now you know the guy.
Yeah, I've photographed him on plenty of occasions, and he refers, he wants his photos of what happens because of... He's a very well-known person here in the county, yeah. And so, you know, it's potentially a newsworthy situation happening there, and, you know.
Wow, we were all really concerned.
Absolutely,
wait a minute, this is not us.
No,
get that a lot, we're used to it, so.
For sure, yeah.
That's why we were kind of like, oh my God, this here we go again. So thank you.
Yeah, and I was going out there to give it, a disclaimer of, you know, hey, sorry about the profanity and everything going on. You know, it was, just still doing my live video right now, so I'm going to finish up outside. So, no, you're okay.
But
thank you so much.
I appreciate your answering the question because
of course. Absolutely. 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 No problem. All right. So it looks like Calvin and his group got access to Gregory Diaz's office. So they're going up there now to speak with him and hopefully clear up some of the grievances and stuff that they have. So as you saw, things got a little testy earlier with the Matthew Coulter and some profanity going on in there earlier. I didn't know any of that was going to happen, so I stepped out. I apologize for that. That's on the beginning of this video. So we saw Calvin there, talking about some of the grievances that he has with the Board of Supervisors and the county. We'll be following this the recall efforts.